இந்தோனேஷியா ஸ்பெயின் பார்த்தா கடைசியில் ஆரம்பிக்கிறது. நம்ம ஆரம்பிக்குமா? Good morning, students. We have seen the properties of a modulus of a complex number. So we'll recall the properties of the modulus of a complex number now. So we have seen these properties already. So the first one is modulus of z bar is equal to modulus of z, modulus of z1 into z2 is equal to modulus of z1 into modulus of z2, modulus of z1 by z2 is equal to modulus of z1 by modulus of z2, then modulus of z1 plus z2 is less than or equal to modulus of z1 plus modulus of z2. then modulus of z1 minus z2 is greater than or equal to modulus z1 minus modulus of z2. So these are the few properties we have seen in our previous class. So now we are going to continue with exercise 2.5. Exercise 2.5, we have done already few problems. So today we will start with question number 6. Question number 6, given modulus of z minus 2 by z is equal to 2. Then we have to show that the greatest value of modulus of z is equal to root 3 plus 1. And least value of modulus of z is equal to root 3 minus 1. So we have to prove this now. So we know that, so this we have used in problem number 5, this property, modulus of z1 plus z2 is greater than or equal to modulus of z1 minus modulus of z2. So this is a property, this also we have seen already and we also have used in the problem. So now given modulus of z minus 2 by z is equal to 2. So we'll take that as z plus minus 2 by z. So what is this? So this is greater than or equal to modulus of z minus modulus of minus 2 by z. So now the left hand side is 2, it is given as 2. So 2 is greater than or equal to modulus of z minus, here we have minus 2, modulus of z1 by z2 can be taken as modulus of z1 by z2. Therefore, this is modulus of minus 2. Modulus of minus 2 is nothing but 2 and modulus of z. So, 2 by modulus of z. Now, this also we can write it as modulus of z minus 2 by modulus of z less than or equal to 2. So, you have learnt this in basic algebra in plus 1, when modulus of x minus a is less than or equal to r, then we have minus r is less than or equal to x minus a is less than or equal to r. This you have studied in your plus 1. So this result can be written as modulus of z minus 2 by modulus of z, that is minus 2 is less than or equal to modulus of z minus 2 by modulus of z less than or equal to 2. So from this we get two values, that is modulus of z minus 2 by modulus of z is less than or equal to 2 and modulus of z minus 2 by modulus of z is greater than or equal to minus 2. So we take this and this. So now consider this. Multiply throughout by modulus of z, because here we are having modulus of z in the denominator. Multiply throughout by modulus of z, we get modulus of z square minus 2 is less than or equal to 2 into modulus of z. And similarly, here we get modulus of z square minus 2 is greater than or equal to minus 2 modulus of z. Then, so this can be written as modulus of z square minus 2 modulus of z, and this minus 2 you take to the other side, it becomes plus 2. And this is modulus of z square minus 2 modulus of z, bring this side, so it becomes plus 2 modulus of z is greater than or equal to 2. So here we can complete the square. So this can be written as, we have to take it as a minus b the whole square. So to take that, we need a plus 1 here. So add both the sides with 1. So modulus of z square minus 2 modulus of z plus 1 is less than or equal to 2 plus 1. Similarly, here also we can add both the sides with plus 1. So plus 1 is greater than or equal to 2 plus 1. Therefore, see here, this is a square minus 2ab plus b square. So it can be written as modulus of z minus 1 the whole square less than or equal to 3. And this is modulus of z plus 1 the whole square greater than or equal to 3. So now, taking square root both the sides, this becomes, we take only the positive square root, therefore modulus of z minus 1 is less than or equal to root 3. So modulus of z is less than or equal to root 3 plus 1, and from here we get modulus of z plus 1 is greater than or equal to root 3. So modulus of z is greater than or equal to root 3 minus 1. So from this we conclude that root 3 plus 1 is the greatest value of modulus of z. And root 3 minus 1 is the least value of modulus of z. So then we'll go to the next question. Question number 7. Exercise 2.5, 7th question. So question number 7. If z1, z2, z3 are three complex numbers such that modulus of z1 is equal to 1, modulus of z2 is equal to 2, modulus of z3 is equal to 3, and modulus of z1 plus z2 plus z3 is equal to 1, we have to prove. So, to prove is modulus of 9 z1 z2 plus 4 z1 z3 plus z1 z2 z3 is equal to 6. We have to prove this. So, now modulus of z1 is equal to 1. So, square both the sides. Squaring, we get modulus of z1 square is equal to 1 square. And we know that modulus of z square is equal to z bar. Therefore, this is z1 into z1 bar is equal to 1. So, from this we get z1 is equal to 1 by z1 bar. So, similarly, modulus of z2 is equal to 2. So modulus of z square is equal to 4. So the same way we get z2 is equal to 4 by z2 bar. And modulus of z3 is equal to 3. Therefore z3 is equal to 9 by z3 bar, that is conjugate, it is z2 conjugate, z3 conjugate, and all this. Now it is given modulus of z1 plus z2 plus z3 is equal to 1. So here we will substitute that. So what you get, z1 is 1 by z1 conjugate and z2 is 4 by z2 conjugate and z3 is 9 by z3 conjugate equal to 1. So now here you take LCM. So LCM is z1 conjugate plus z2 conjugate plus z3 conjugate. Therefore here we get, because z1 conjugate, sorry, so LCM is z1 conjugate into z2 conjugate into z3 conjugate. So here we have z1 conjugate, therefore this is 1 into z2 conjugate into z3 conjugate plus z2 conjugate is there, so 4 into z1 conjugate into z3 conjugate plus z3 conjugate is there, so 9 into z1 conjugate into z2 conjugate modulus is equal to 1. So now we know that modulus of z1 plus z2 plus z3 is equal to modulus of z1 plus modulus of z2 plus modulus of z3, and modulus of z1, z2, z3 is equal to modulus of z1 into modulus of z2 into modulus of z3. All these properties we are going to use it here. So this becomes modulus of z2, z3 plus 4 z1 z3 plus 9 z1 z2 the whole conjugate by z1 z2 z2 conjugate modulus is equal to 1. So now we know that modulus of z bar is equal to modulus of z. So modulus of z bar is equal to modulus of z. So we get modulus of z2, z3 plus 4 z1, z3 plus 9 z1, z2 by modulus of z1, z2, z3 is equal to 1. So now we get this denominator, this is we can take to the other side and also it can be written as, so z modulus of z2 z3 plus 4 into z1 z3 plus 9 into z1 z2 is equal to modulus of z1 z2 z3 can be written as modulus of z1 into modulus of z2 into modulus of z3 carrying to the other side. Therefore this is equal to, now modulus of z1 is 1 and modulus of z2 is 2 and modulus of z3 is 3. Therefore we get modulus of 9 z1 z2 plus 4 z1 z3 plus z2 z3 is equal to 6. Hence we have proved the result. Okay, now coming to question number 8, exercise 2.5, question number 8. If the area of the triangle formed by the vertices z, iz and z plus iz is 50 square units, find the value of modulus of z. So we have to find value of modulus of z. So here we have Ez and Iez as the vertices of the triangle. So you should know this. Ez, when it is multiplied by I, so it becomes Iez. So when a complex number is multiplied by I, it is rotated 90 degree in the anti-clockwise direction, anti-clockwise or counter-clockwise direction. So the angle between these two will be 90 degree, that is Ez and Iez will be 90 degree. Therefore, we say that the triangle formed with these three vertices will be a right angle triangle. So we can find the area of the right angle triangle. So area of the triangle, so area of the triangle is equal to, we know when it is a right angle triangle, it is half into base into height. So we'll take it as half into modulus of Ez into modulus of Iez. So it is given as 50, area of the triangle is equal to 50. Therefore, this is 1 by 2 into modulus of Ez into modulus of I is 1. We know that modulus of I is 1. So this is modulus of Ez is equal to 50. Therefore, modulus of Ez square is equal to 100. Taking this 2 to the other side, it becomes 100. So modulus of Ez is equal to 10. We take only the positive square root. Therefore, modulus of Ez is equal to 10. So we have got the result. Now coming to the next question. Question number 10. Question number 9 already we have done. Question number 10. Question number 10, before going to that, we'll see a formula for that. That is square root of A plus IB. Square root of A plus IB is equal to, this is a formula you should know. It is equal to plus or minus square root of modulus of Ez plus A by 2 plus I into B by modulus of B into square root of modulus of Ez minus A by 2. So, where Ez is taken as A plus IB and B is not equal to 0. So, here we have two cases. You have to remember two cases. That is, when B is negative in the complex number, when B is negative, we get B by modulus of B is equal to minus 1. And so, X and Y will be of different sign. Both will be of different sign. That is, if one is plus, the other one will be minus. So, when B is positive, B by modulus of B will be equal to 1. And so we will have X and Y will be of same sign. So same sign in the sense both will be positive or both will be negative. So this you should remember always. So we'll take question number 10 now. So find the square root of, we'll do the third subdivision. 10th question, third subdivision. So, third subdivision is minus 5 minus 12i. So, here A is equal to minus 5, B is equal to minus 12, and this is Ez. So, we have to find modulus of Ez. So, modulus of Ez is equal to square root of minus 5 the whole square plus minus 12 the whole square. So, it is equal to square root of 25 plus 144. So which is equal to square root of 169. Square root of 169 is 13. So now we'll take the formula. So square root of a plus ib is equal to plus or minus square root of modulus of z plus a by 2 plus I into b by modulus of b into square root of modulus of z minus a by 2. So this is the square root formula. So we are going to apply here. So square root of minus 5 minus 12 I is equal to plus or minus. So modulus of z is equal to 13. So square root of 13, a is minus 5. So 13 minus 5 by 2 plus I into b. B is minus 12. So minus 12 by modulus of minus 12. So here b is negative. B is negative. Therefore, we will have a negative sign here. So minus 1 into square root of 13 minus of minus 5 gives you plus 5 by 2. So it is equal to plus or minus square root of 13 minus 5 is 8. So 8 by 2 root of, and this is minus I into root 18 by 2. So it is equal to plus or minus root 4 minus I into root 9, which gives you plus or minus 2 minus 3i. So similarly, the first and the second subdivision can be done. So exercise 2.5 is completed. So now we'll see an example. Example 2.14. So example 2.14, it is asked to show that the points or the vertices of an equilateral triangle. Example 2.14. Show that the points or the vertices of an equilateral triangle. So what are the vertices given? 1 minus 1 by 2 plus I root 3 by 2 and minus 1 by 2 minus I root 3 by 2. So these are the vertices given. So these vertices form an equilateral triangle, we have to show. So what is meant by an equilateral triangle? When the sides of a triangle are equal, the triangle is said to be an equilateral triangle. So here we have to find the distance of the sides. That is, see here, this is 1. So 1 means it is 1 plus I 0. 1 plus 0, I say. And this is what? Minus comma plus. So minus comma plus, and this is minus comma minus, and this is plus comma plus. So they all, you can draw a rough diagram. So we know that x axis is the real axis and y axis is the imaginary axis. Therefore plus comma plus, so take it here approximately, then minus comma plus will be somewhere here and minus comma minus will be here. So, we get a triangle here. So, if you take this as A, B and C, then we have to find the distance between A, B, B, C and C. So, now, so we'll find the distance now. That is the length of the sides. So modulus of z1 is equal to 1, z2 is equal to minus 1 by 2 plus I root 3 by 2 and Z3 is equal to minus 1 by 2 minus I root 3 by 2. So now we will find first Z1 minus Z2. So Z1 minus Z2, so 1 minus of minus 1 by 2 plus I root 3 by 2. So it is equal to 1 plus 1 by 2. So 1 plus 1 by 2 minus I root 3 by 2. So it is equal to 3 by 2 minus I root 3 by 2. So it is equal to modulus, we know it is root of x square plus y square. So this is root of 3 by 2 the whole square plus root 3 by 2 the whole square. So it is equal to 9 by 4 plus 3 by 4. So it is equal to root of 12 by 4, which is equal to root 3. So similarly, we have to find now modulus of Z2 minus Z3. Modulus of Z2 minus Z3. So Z2 is minus 1 by 2 plus I root 3 by 2 minus of Z3. Therefore, you can take it as plus 1 by 2 plus I root 3 by 2. So it is equal to minus 1 by 2 plus root 3. 1 by 2 will get cancelled. So it becomes modulus of I 2i root 3 by 2. So 2 will get cancelled and modulus of I is 1. So we get it is equal to square root of root 3 square, which is equal to root 3. Then modulus of Z3 minus Z1. So modulus of Z3 minus Z1. So it is equal to modulus of minus 1 by 2 minus I root 3 by 2 minus 1. So it gives us minus 1 by 2 minus 1 is minus 3 by 2 and minus I root 3 by 2. So modulus, so it gives you 3 by 2 the whole square. So 9 by 4 plus root 3 square is 3. So 3 by 4, which is equal to root 12 by 4, which is equal to root 3. So now we have seen that all the 3 are equal. So we say that the given sides, the given points form an equilateral triangle. Therefore, the given points or the given complex numbers form an equilateral triangle. Okay, other examples are similar to exercise problems, so that you can, it can be done by you for practice. We will go to the next topic. So the next topic is locus of complex number. Locus of a complex number. So what is meant by locus? So this already you have seen in plus 1. What is a locus? So locus is nothing but the path traced by a moving point. Path traced by a moving point gives you the locus. So the best example is a circle. So when you take a circle, so a moving point, a point moves and it gives you a circle in such a way that the distance between the moving point and a fixed point will be the same, and the path traced is called as a circle. The distance between the moving point and the fixed point is called as a radius, and the fixed point is called as a center. So the path traced by the moving point here gives you a circle. So locus is nothing but path traced by a moving point. So exercise 2.6. First question. So Z, if Z is equal to X plus IY is a complex number, and it is given modulus of Z minus 4I by Z plus 4I is equal to 1, then we have to show that the locus of Z is a real axis. Locus of Z is a real axis. We have to show this. So now we'll consider this. So modulus of Z minus 4i by modulus of by Z plus 4i. So we know that modulus of Z1 by Z2 is equal to modulus of Z1 by modulus of Z2, and the place of Z we can take X plus IY. So X plus IY minus 4i by X plus IY plus 4i is equal to 1. So now we'll write it in the standard form, that is the rectangular form. So we get modulus of X plus I into Y minus 4 by modulus of X plus I into Y plus 4 is equal to 1. So cross multiplying, we get modulus of X plus I into Y minus 4 is equal to modulus of X plus I into Y plus 4. So now we know modulus of X plus I y is equal to root of X square plus Y square. So this gives you root of X square plus Y minus 4 the whole square is equal to square root of X square plus Y plus 4 the whole square. Now squaring both the sides, square root can be removed, and inside the square root we can expand. Therefore it gives us X square plus, this is of the form A minus B the whole square. So using the identity we get X square plus 16 minus 8Y is equal to X square plus Y square. Here we use A plus B the whole square identity. So Y square plus 16 plus 8Y. So now both the sides we can cancel a few terms. That is X square gets cancelled, Y square gets cancelled, 16 also gets cancelled. So we have minus 8y is equal to, okay, now exercise 2.6. Question number 2. If Z is equal to X plus IY, it's a complex number such that imaginary part of 2Z plus 1 by Iz plus 1 is equal to 0. We have to show that the locus of Z is, so to prove is 2x square plus 2y square plus x minus 2y is equal to 0. So now we'll consider 2z plus 1 by iz plus 1. So in the place of z, we'll substitute x plus i y. So 2 into x plus i y plus 1 divided by I into x plus I y plus 1. So that is equal to, we'll write it in the rectangular form. So it is 2x plus 1, that is the standard form, plus I 2y by here I into x plus I square into y. I square is minus 1, we know. So it is 1 minus y. So this is the real part plus ix. So now we will to bring it to the standard form, again we have to multiply by the conjugate of the denominator. So conjugate of the denominator is 1 minus y minus ix. So we multiply both numerator and denominator with that. So 1 minus y minus ix. Now it is equal to, so we'll multiply the numerator. So we have seen already how to multiply. So we'll just write this. So 2x plus 1 plus i2y into 1 minus y minus ix, and the denominator is a plus ib into a minus ib is equal to a square plus b square, or x plus iy into x minus iy is x square plus y square. So here we get 1 minus y the whole square plus x square. Now it is given that the imaginary part of that is equal to 0. So we will take the imaginary part. So imaginary part, we know the multiplication of two complex numbers. So to get the imaginary part, we multiply the real part with the imaginary part, and then the imaginary part with the real part. So given imaginary part of 2z plus 1 by iz plus 1 is equal to 0. So we will take only the imaginary part. So imaginary part is the real part with the imaginary part. So 2x plus 1 into minus x, then with the imaginary part with the real part. So plus 2y into 1 minus y, and the denominator we have this. So 1 minus y the whole square plus x square is equal to 0. So now cross multiplying, the denominator goes to the other side. So it becomes 0. So we get 2x plus 1 into minus x plus 2y into 1 minus y is equal to 0. So multiplying this, we get minus 2x square minus x plus 2y minus 2y square is equal to 0. So now here we have 2x square. So 2x square 2x square multiply throughout by minus sign. So we get 2x square plus 2y square minus 2y plus x is equal to 0. Hence, proof. So we have completed the second question. Now coming to example 2.18. So example 2.18, given complex number z is equal to 3 plus 2y, represent the complex number z, iz and z plus iz in one organ diagram, and show that these complex numbers form an isosceles right triangle. So isosceles means two sides of the triangle are equal, and it is said that isosceles right triangle. So we have to use Pythagoras theorem also. So what is z? z is equal to 3 plus 2y and iz is I into 3 plus 2y. So this is equal to 3i minus 2 and this is equal to 3 plus 2y plus 3i minus 2. So which is equal to 1 plus 5y. So writing in ordered pair, this is 3 comma 2 and this is minus 2 comma 3 and this is 1 comma 5. So you should be very careful in writing this. The real part should be written first and then the imaginary part. So now plotting this on the rough diagram. So the real axis is the x axis and the imaginary axis is the y axis. So 3 comma 2. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So first one is 3 comma 2, so 3 comma 2, we'll take it here. Then minus 2 comma 3, so minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc. So minus 2 comma 3 will be here and 1 comma 5 will be somewhere here. So we get a triangle like this. So if you take this as A, this is B and this is C. So we have to find now the distance between them. So we'll find AB. So AB is modulus of EZ plus IEZ minus EZ. So AB square. Or here we can minus Z gets cancelled. So modulus of IEZ, which is equal to modulus, we know that modulus of I is 1, so it gives you modulus of z. Therefore AB square will be modulus of z square. So modulus of z square will be modulus of z will be root, so z square root will be removed. So 9 plus 4, which is equal to 13. Then BC square. BC square is IEZ minus EZ plus IEZ. So it gives us modulus of minus EZ. So BC square, therefore we take square here. So it is equal to modulus of EZ square. So modulus of EZ square is modulus of minus z, so minus 3 minus 2y the whole square, which gives us 9 plus 4, which is equal to 13 again. Then ca square is modulus of z minus iz the whole square, so which is equal to 5 minus I the whole square, so it is equal to 25 plus 1, which is equal to 26. So now see here, AB is equal to BC is equal to 13. Therefore, the triangle is isosceles and we get AB square plus BC square is equal to CA square. That is 13 plus 13 is equal to 26. Therefore, the triangle is isosceles right angle triangle. So we have proved that the triangle formed in the organ plane is a isosceles right triangle. Hence proved. Thank you.